Welcome to Special Report. On tonight's programme, the team is in Toulon with English rugby stars Johnny Wilkinson, Andrew Sheridan, Simon Shaw, Nick Kennedy and the brothers Delon and Stefan Armitage. Wilkinson led the exodus to the club on the Côte d'Azur 3 years ago, and the talent train has continued to pace ever since, the players lured away from home by the club's wealthy owner. His goal is simple, to be the best side in France and Europe. And the season started well, with 7 wins out of 8, putting them top of France's domestic league table. Gail Davis has the story.
Behind the sun, sea, style and glamour you'd come to expect from the Côte d'Azur, Toulon is a town that means business. A naval port that shaped the history of the area, it's the so-called rough diamond of its illustrious and more glittering neighbours in the south of France. 6 years ago, Mourad Boudjellal, a second-generation immigrant born and bred in Toulon, who made his millions out of comic books, sold a fantasy to his town. A vision to reignite the Toulonnais passion and pride.
Suivre le RCT, consomme du RCT.
People follow our city because I think sincerely in today's world it does them good. It does them good because it allows them to escape their worries.
Boudjellal opened his checkbook and invited some of the world's biggest stars to join him on his adventure. And so began a French rugby revolution that's now in part made in England.
For me, myself, I bring a kind of obsessional side that I think links in with that kind of the obsession that there is for rugby here, which means that I live, breathe and eat and sleep it, and up until the moment when it's over. So I think that in a way is my way of communicating with these guys, without needing to speak, is just by turning up and saying that I live for this as well.
Wilkinson blazed the trail back in 2009 when he joined the French club. Now there are 6 in the Toulon ranks that have worn the red rose of England. Pre-match cultures and rituals in Toulon have taken some getting used to.
There's a bit more of a football mentality here in terms of a little bit more face paint and maybe a bit more sort of vocal on the pitch. We played at Montpellier last week and I went to warm up and the whole stand just booed me as I walked around.
King's home.
Yeah, it was a King's home times three type thing. It was just very intense.
Paying the big bucks is one thing, and with almost twice the salary cap of English teams, Toulon certainly do. But buying the players' soul and passion has always been the challenge, and that's what's led the club across the English Channel.
Ce sont des guerriers.
They are warriors, the English. They don't like defeat. They are very professional, and they adapt more easily to the top 14 because they understand promotion and relegation. Because of the presence of Johnny Wilkinson, who is an icon in England, it's true that when English players are approached by clubs, Toulon is a club that appeals because they want to play with Johnny Wilkinson.
It's not just those in England who Wilkinson appeals to. South Africa World Cup winner Bakis Botha is full of admiration for him and the other English expats.
Johnny has been a legend in English rugby, so it's just great to be with him, associated with him, and play with him in a team like RCT. It's good to have the guys around, and it's an experience and a journey for me, especially with the English guys. I've played against, especially against England and British and Irish Lions, Andrew and the guys. It's just amazing.
For the head coach, it's meant a reunion with a number of the players that were his undoing as the France coach. Twice in World Cup semi-finals, he suffered at the hands of some of his English contingent. Now he's hoping they're the ones to provide the missing pieces in a jigsaw that was so nearly completed last season when Toulon were runners-up in the top 14 and Amnin Challenge Cup.
All the time, I say, I have a lot of respect for them because they have a culture of the training, a culture of the sport, and I like their culture, very professional. Sometimes for the French,
people. You have to push them to train, push them to play. When an England or an Anglo-Saxon people is not this. If they play rugby, they play rugby. They train rugby, they train rugby. They are all the time at 100%.
Je sais que il y a beaucoup de pays dans.
A lot of people think Toulon is a club with a millionaire with no soul, and that I spend endless sums of money to get the best players in the world, almost like a team on PlayStation. But it is now self-financed.
Like many clubs in France, their ground, the Stade Félix Mayol, is owned by the local council. It holds almost 15,000 and they sell out every home game. And the club have over 1,000 sponsors who've bought into the Toulon dream. Wearing the shirt comes with responsibilities. You went to go and buy your bread this morning, and the woman knew the result, didn't she?
Yes, yeah, they know, they're very knowledgeable about everything. They love the scrum out here more than anything. The scrum's the biggest thing to the people of Toulon. But no, she was, she's a season ticket holder, and she's thrilled with the start as well. So I got, she gave me my coffee, was free this morning. So. I'm waiting to see what happens when, well, hopefully we won't lose a game, but I don't think I'll get a free coffee if we do.
When Stephen Armitage left London Irish mid-contract to fight for a place in the star-studded side, it was seen as a risky move. Last season, he also tested positive for morphine after taking approved painkillers for his back. He and the club have vowed he did nothing wrong, but he will appear before the French Rugby Union at the end of the month. Despite that, he was, in his first season, voted Player of the Year by the influential French rugby newspaper Midi Olympique.
You've got to try and break into a team where there are so many international players like Giovanni Kirk, Juan Lubi. There's quite a lot of competition. And it was hard, but once started going, the guys just welcomed me quite easily, and it just went on from there.
The best in France, but still not outstanding enough for the Rugby Football Union and Stuart Lancaster, who will only pick overseas-based players in exceptional circumstances.
We know when Stefan is playing, we need another very good line-out. In line-out, because it's a weakness of Stefan is this. On the ground, on the field, for me, is the better. It's the best, like Pocock, the Australian, like Richie McCaw, like this. Is this player fantastic in defense, on the ground, around the field? It's better, and he carries the ball a lot. If Lancaster doesn't take him, he has his reason.
I feel sorry for him that, you know, he had to come over to Toulon to be the player he is, because I still think he can offer England a lot. I think, you know, the fact that he, you know, with all these international, not just at Toulon, because at Gaston, Toulouse, guys like that, you know, really respect him. And the fact that, you know, he didn't even, you know, get on that trip to South Africa, I thought, you know, it was very disappointing. And hopefully, I know if he continues doing the things that he's doing, you know, hopefully he can still, you know, get a few more caps under his belt.
Got all this, and it's beautiful, and it's warm, and fabulous lifestyle. But with it, you've all had to put your England careers on hold, haven't you?
That's been tough. That was obviously a massive decision. We haven't come here to give up on England. That's, you know, that's still there. You know, we still want to be involved, and, you know, we're going to keep working. And that's why we play the sport, because we want to play at the top level and with the top players.
It's not a hard and fast no for the guys to play for England. We were just discussing earlier about how Stu had spoken to Steph about just missing out on the tour. And, you know, it's not a definite no if there are special circumstances, which definitely for these two, I think that they are, you know, special players. So there can be special circumstances that they can go back and still play for England.
So England honours remain an ambition. But for now, the focus is on winning silverware at Toulon, and it starts with the Heineken Cup this weekend.